Hey, what's up, you guys? Today I have a beauty and/or makeup haul. I've been kind of collecting things over the past like couple weeks or whatever, and I thought it was finally, whoa, what is happening over here? I thought it was finally time that I kind of like showed you the things that I've been hoarding. So I have a little bit of everything. I have some things from Ulta, some things from Macy's, and then I have a box from Elf. So I'm just gonna jump right into it. The first thing is probably the oldest thing here. I actually kept the box so that I could make this video. This is the Bronze Goddess Heat Wave Highlighter from Estee Lauder. I'm wearing it today. If you can see my highlight going on, I think it is gorgeous. Heat Wave is a like, it was discontinued and really popular, and they brought it back. It looks like this. I think I talked about it in one of my favorites videos. But it's just a really pretty golden highlight. I think it would be really pretty on dark skins, especially. But I still think it's pretty. I mean, it might be a little bit dark for me, but I just can't get over how pretty it is. So the compact is gorgeous as well. It's got this teal thing on the bottom. I've already kind of talked about this, but I wanted to kind of add it in this video just in case you didn't see that last one and you wanted to know about it. Speaking of highlighter, the next thing that I have is actually something that I bought during the 21 Days of Beauty at Ulta, and it is this Tarte Amazonian Clay 12-Hour Highlight in the shade Stunner. This is the only highlight shade that I was interested in getting. I think they have three in the line. But this is the only one that I thought like that was really pretty. The compact looks like this. Really plain, but you know, I really like this like beigey, goldy color. And then this is what the highlight looks like. It doesn't really look like anything crazy in the pan, but then when you swirl it on your finger and kind of swipe it on, I think it just looks so gorgeous. Again, really, really pretty. It's got kind of like a pinky, peachy undertone. But yeah, I love it. It's so beautiful. And I got this at like half price, I think. It normally goes for like 28, so I got it for 14, which I thought was a steal because I don't think I would ever buy this at 28. Just because, I don't know, it does look similar to some things that I have in my collection, but I'm a collector and a lover, so I thought I would try this out. So really love that. And then another thing I got from the 21 Days of Beauty, I'm actually wearing on my face right now. This was something that I've been kind of looking at here and there. I only got one of the two. I wanted to get both, but these were also 50% off. This is the Lorac Unzipped Gold Palette. I wanted to get both of this and the original, kind of like a two for one palette deal, but this was the only one that was available when I got online. The other one was sold out. But I really do like this. I'm wearing it on my eyes today. It's the first day that I've tried it out. In this box, you get the palette and then you get a sample of the Lorac Behind the Scenes Eye Primer, which I've used before and I really do like. I really like Lorac eyeshadows in general because I love my Lorac Pro 2. So I wanted to try the Unzipped. This is what it looks like. And then it's got this little like sheet covering the shadows, a big mirror, and then these are what the colors look like. Today on my eyes, I used Undressed as kind of like a base for my primer. I used Unlocked in the inner corner. And then I took Uninhibited, which is this like kind of neutrally color on the lid, and then Undeniable in the crease. And it's just giving me a really soft look. Like, I'm not used to not having like a dark crease color going on. So this is something different. I really do like the Lorac shadows. And the pans are really big as well. They're really nice. I might consider looking into the original Lorac Unzipped, but for now, the Lorac Gold is really pretty as well. And then I got some things from NYX when I went in to Ulta to get the Tarte highlight. NYX was on sale, buy one, get one half off. And I originally went in there to get this bad boy. This is the NYX Glitter Primer. My Naked 3 palette is very glittery, and I don't know if, I'm assuming all of the Naked 3s are like that. And even with a normal primer, they still come off really dusty and powdery and just not the greatest. So I thought I would try and use a glitter primer for them because they do have a lot of sparkle. Glitter primers are usually a lot more sticky so that glitter can stick to them when you use it on the eyes. But I thought that I would try this out with the Naked 3 palette. So that's why I got it. I mean, you can use it with other shadows or other glitters, but my main thing was for the Naked 3. I love that palette. It just doesn't perform as well as I would like, or as well as like other shadows in my collection. So I picked this up. It wasn't too bad. I think it was like $5. So super cool. And then I got three more of the NYX Prismatic shadows. I love these. My favorite one is this one that I already have called Mermaid. And it's just like a icy kind of like teal color. So I wanted to pick some more up to kind of like play with them. I do have a couple more, but they're all kind of more neutrally shades. So I wanted to get some kind of fun colors for the spring and summer. So the first one I got was the shade Bewitched, which looks like this. It's kind of like a like sparkly or metallic is the right word. Olive green. So that's what that looks like. Oh, it's so pretty. This is so much more pigmented than that other olive green shade that I got from Ulta a while back. Then I got the shade Golden Peach, which really spoke to me. It looks like this in the pan, kind of like, you know, metallic as well. And then it looks like that. So those two would actually be kind of pretty together for a look. Maybe put the green on the lower lash line, I don't know. And then I got the shade Frostbite, which this actually was broken when I got it. I had to press it back into this pan. But it looks like this. It's kind of like a duochrome-y, like white silvery color. Looks like that. I have used that one on the inner corner of a look. You can see it's like, it's got like kind of a duochrome shift almost, like a whitish pink. So really, really excited about these. I do love the NYX Prismatic shadows, like I said, and I'm excited to use them. So yeah, now let's get into this e.l.f. haul. I've been patiently awaiting making this video until this box came, and it came today. So I'm really excited. I've never ordered anything from e.l.f. Normally, I'm just like, I just buy it if I see it at the store or something. But there was one product I wanted that was an online exclusive, and it finally came back in stock. And you'll see what that is when I get into this. So this is what we got going on. You can see there's like a lot of stuff in there. Let me make some room for this box. The first thing that I got were these e.l.f. makeup remover cloths. This is a 2-pack. I hear people rave about these all the time, and frankly, I wanted to get the free gift that came with a $25 purchase. So I was like, I'll always need makeup remover wipes. They come in a 2-pack. You get 40 of them. And this was a better deal than like just buying two individually. So I got that. Then I picked up this pointed powder brush. I love e.l.f.'s brushes. Like, the whole line of e.l.f. is, like, you know, really inexpensive, and their brushes are really good quality. This is what it looks like. It kind of reminded me of that Marc Jacobs bronzer brush, I think it is. And I think this would be really nice for bronzer or powder or even just, like, sweeping off bake under the eyes. I just think this is a really pretty brush, and it's really, really soft and nice. So picked that up. And then, oh, there it is. I was like, is my thing I ordered even in here? Oh, I got an extra brush, you guys. I didn't order this. Let me see. Yeah, I didn't even order this brush, unless it came as part of the gift, but it's not in the gift bag, so that's cool. This is the e.l.f. blush brush. I totally got this for free, and it's not even on my receipt, so that's super cool. Free brushes. I can always use a new brush. This is the e.l.f. blush brush. I actually do have this brush already, but, you know, I use this sometimes for blush, but then also for, like, sweeping off bake, putting on powder, even sometimes for highlighter. So, this is super cool. It's a totally, like, a free brush, I guess. Shoot. I'm down. The next thing that I picked up was the e.l.f. Beautifully Bare Luminous Matte Primer. So, what made me want to try this out is because the fact that it says luminous and matte. I love a matte finish, but sometimes I kind of get into the mood of, like, maybe I should have a little bit of glowiness going on. So the fact that this was luminous and matte really, like, you know, sprung my attention. And this is just a face primer. It says it primes the skin for long wear and also moisturizes, brightens, and refines skin's appearance. So it looks like this. Comes in this little tube. It's, you know, smaller than I thought it would be. But then with primer, you don't really need a whole lot. It's clear, supposedly. No, you just, like, screw this off. Let me squeeze some out. Woo, it needs to be shook. It needs to be shook. It's real liquidy. It's got, like, it's a white consistency. But I feel like it's separated, you know, because there's, like, liquid going on. Yeah, there we go. That's better. So yeah, it's just like a white kind of consistency. Let me just kind of rub that in. It's just like a clear, it doesn't feel silicone-y like the Smashbox primer does. But I don't know. It feels like something that I'm going to try out because I can't make any kind of judgments about it just yet. But it'll be fun to try. And then I'm going to save what I actually wanted to order for last, but let's dig into this little gift pack. This is the gift that you got with a $25 purchase. It's worth $14. So let's see. The first thing that I see is this e.l.f. All Over Color Stick in the shade Pink Lemonade. It says it instantly brightens eyes, lips, and face. So I'm not really a big fan of, like, cream products. But I will try this out. Doesn't go out for free. It looks like this. Kind of reminds me of, like, those Maybelline blushes and stuff. Let's see. Let's do it on this hand. Ooh, that is pretty for the summertime. That might even be pretty for just, like, on the lips, because I'm not a fan of cream blushes, but if I can use it as, like, a lipstick or something, like, shoot. I'll be all about it. And it is really pretty for spring and summer. Cool, cool, yo. Cool, cool. I'm gonna wipe that off before it gets on anywhere. Then, oh my gosh, this is super cool. I was gonna buy an eyelash curler from e.l.f. and I got one in this kit. So that's super cool. I don't have an eyelash curler. Every once in a while, I'm like, oh, maybe I should get one, or maybe, I don't know, but super cool. Freedom. Freedom. What is in this box? Oh, there's extra stuff. Extra. Okay. Then there's this lengthening and defining mascara. Looks like this. I'm not going to open this one because I don't want it to, like, dry out before I actually get to use it. But I do love things that lengthen. And the brush, you know, according to the picture, it looks really simple, like, really easy to use. Then I have this e.l.f. Baked Trio Eyeshadow in Peach Please. Peach Please. So it looks like this. I don't know. I've tried some of their baked products. I wasn't really a super fan of the ones that I have tried. But let me swatch each color and just see. Some of these might even be pretty as, like, a highlighter, the two lighter shades. So those are what the colors look like. Let me swipe. I mean, they're pretty. They're pretty. I definitely have shades like this in my collection, but I mean, to get it for free, I'm not complaining. And then the last thing that is in this free set is something that I actually already have. I don't know, maybe I'll give it away. I don't know. But this is the e.l.f. contouring brush. It actually, let me show you the one that I have so that I don't have to get my greasy hands all over this. This is what the brush looks like. It's just one of those like flat kind of contouring brushes. I like to use it down my nose. It kind of reminds me of like the NARS Eda brush that everybody was like going crazy over. So this is what that brush looks like. Get it in this set. It's super cool. This was a really cool gift set. I'm like really pleased. Let me clean off this desk area a little bit so that I can make way for the grand finale here. So yeah, the one thing that I really wanted, which is why I made this purchase, let me put this up here, is the e.l.f. Mad for Matte 2 palette. This is an online-only exclusive. I saw it in Kathleen Leitz's palette collection video, and ever since I've been hunting it down. You can't find it in stores because it's online only, but it's been out of stock forever. So if you see this video and you like this palette, I would jump on e.l.f.'s website and get it because who knows when it's gonna go back out of stock. But it's a really slim palette. It looks like this. This palette was only $10, so totally cool. Oh my gosh. This is what it looks like. You can see those warm matte tones with like the purples and the browns. I think this palette will go awesomely with this NYX Prismatic in peach, golden peach. But yeah, this is such a pretty palette. Let me swatch some of the colors for you guys. Whew. Let's do this purple, of course. Are you kidding me? It's so pretty. And then maybe some of this red or like this burgundy tone. Super pretty. And then we'll do like this peachy tone. So, yeah, I mean, the swatches are really nice and pigmented, and again, they're really soft, like matte shadows, which I don't have a lot of. I tend to be drawn for more of the shimmery shades, but then when it comes down to making a look, it's kind of like, where's my matte shades though? So this comes really in handy. I wear a lot of warm tones on my eyes, so this is really nice. You get a matte black, you get a matte like white, kind of like highlighty shade. I think this is a really nice palette. They do have a Mad for Matte one that has more cool tones, like more grays and more browns. But I thought this warm tone shade would be perfect for the colors that I wear on a daily basis. So that is my beauty haul. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I shouldn't have really like done a haul, but I don't know. There's just so many new things coming out that I'm just like loving and like lusting over. But I do think it will be a while before I like, buy any makeup again. I am waiting on the Carly Bible BH Cosmetics palette. I put a pre-order in for that, but that's like the last makeup thing that I'm gonna be buying for a while. I feel, don't quote me on that. But until next time, I hope you guys have a beautiful day. Let me know in the comments what are some new things that you're trying out. And until next time, I will talk to you guys soon. Bye!